Good evening and welcome to We the People. Are India's politicians scared of history? Why does any debate around partition cause the kind of political rumblings it does? We've all seen what happened to Jaswant Singh for writing a book on Jinnah. But are other parties really any different when it comes to re-examining men of the past that they've held up as heroes? Are we in effect too politically correct when it comes to talking about partition? Let me start with Sudhindra Kulkarni, whom we've known as previously as an aide to L.K. Advani, even Atal Bihari Vajpayee. But I remember, actually, in 2005, you're coming on exactly the same program and defending L.K. Advani's comments on Jinnah in Made in Pakistan. Do you believe that there's any difference between what Mr. Advani said and what Mr. Jaswant Singh has said?
No. What Advani ji said in Karachi in 2005 and subsequently elaborated at great length in his autobiography, he projected two sides of Jinnah. Jinnah was a very complex personality, and in fact our recent history has been very complex. There was a positive side to him. He was hailed as an ambassador of Hindu-Muslim unity by none other than Gopal Krishna Gokhale and subsequently Sarojini Naidu. Until the mid-30s, he indeed strove very earnestly, sincerely for Hindu-Muslim unity and for the unity of India becoming independent. But there was a transformation, and this is what Advaniji said, and Jaswant Singh ji has devoted the entire book to a political biography of Jinnah, and he has elaborated this. There is no essential difference.
This is a day when you've actually stepped outside formally of the BJP. Many people would argue that this was coming, in a sense, after the piece you wrote on the reasons for the BJP's poll defeat and the party disassociated itself from that. We'll get more into that later in the program, but I want to ask you, according to you, why does this cause the reaction it does in the BJP and the Sangh Parivar to see Jinnah in what you call a complex way?
No, it's not just the BJP. I think that the entire political establishment needs to examine and re-examine our partition history more objectively. After 60 years of that very tragic episode, we are now a mature nation. We can look at our history more objectively. And it's not a question of projecting our national heroes as villains now. Even Jaswant Singh ji's book, it neither projects Jinnah as a hero.
Nor as a villain.
Not at all. It's an object. And nor, while pointing out serious mistakes committed by Jawaharlal Nehru, Sardar Patel, and other Congress leaders of the time, there is an essential difference between the crime committed by the Muslim League and Jinnah and the mistakes committed by Jawaharlal Nehru and others.
Okay. Chandan Mitra, why reduce history to mathematics?
No, it's not reducing history to mathematics. There is always space for academic research and scholarly work and looking at people in not just in black and white but in grey. But also, there is a political dimension to the whole thing.
And what is the political dimension?
As far as Jinnah is concerned, I think there is no, there is really no complexity. And as far as people are concerned,
Jinnah, there is no complexity.
No complexity. Jinnah was a villain. He was a communal man. He was an architect of Direct Action Day in Calcutta, 16th August 1946.
But as a thinking person, Chandan, can you really use words like villain and heroes for history?
He was a person who led the movement for the vivisection of the country, in which lakhs of people got killed, women got raped, and people got dislocated from
the
home.
So no ambiguity is possible in the reading of history.
No ambiguity. You cannot revisit some people like Hitler, Stalin, Jinnah. They cannot
revisit.
Tubar.com.